First on CBS This Morning, the newest Democrat who wants to take on President Trump next fall. Former Massachusetts Governor Deval Patrick said this morning he is officially running for the Democratic presidential nomination. Patrick has been a CBS News political contributor, but in light of his decision, of course, we're discontinuing that relationship. He joins 17 other Democratic candidates in the race. He will file to get on the primary ballot in New Hampshire later this morning. But first, he joins us from Boston. Governor, good morning. Thank you for being
good
with us.
Good morning, Anthony, and to Gayle and Tony. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
And before, I didn't know that we weren't going to continue to have the consulting relationship. What? I don't understand.
Yes. Sorry, we're going to have to stop meeting like this, or like we used to meet. We may meet more like this. But before we dive in here, we want to look at what you said to us when you were back with us back in June.
I was struck by what I have always sensed, which is that we have a remarkably rich and talented field of candidates. It doesn't bother me one bit that there are a lot of them.
You wish you were there?
Yeah, were you struck by the possibility you could beat all of them?
No, that's not how I was thinking about it, although when I was thinking about it many months ago, one of the questions was, how do you break through in a field this large and this talented without being a celebrity or a or sensationalist? And I'm none of those things.
Well, Governor, you must have decided you can break through. What's changed?
Well, I think what I've decided is you can't know if you can break through if you don't get out there and try. And I think in many respects, and we've talked about this, I've been waiting for a moment like this my whole life. And by that, I don't mean a moment to run for president, but a moment when the appetite for big ideas is big enough for the size of the challenges we face in America. And the anger and anxiety that I hear about and I read about and I see and I witness and listen to in all kinds of corners of the country today is familiar to me for the same reasons, having grown up on the south side of Chicago, the sense that the economy just kind of gets up and kicks you to the curb.
Governor, let's get into some of those ideas, because your campaign slogan is Deval for All, but I think people want to know where you are on the issues. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to give you three issues in quick succession. I'd like
you to
give you short answers.
You're not going to tell me I have to raise my hand, do you?
No, you don't have to raise your hand, but if you could give me shorter answers, and then I promise on the back end you can go as long as you need to fill it out. Number one, do you support Medicare for all?
No, not in the terms we've been talking about. I do support a public option, and if Medicare is that public option, I think it's a great idea.
Do you support eliminating or at least vastly reducing student debt?
Of course, and I think there are other strategies than we've heard about to do just that.
And finally,
and I think we have to do that in order to enable people to reach their potential.
And lastly, before we go deeper on all three, and I am sorry to interrupt, do you believe the wealthy are not paying their fair share and the taxes should go up, particularly in the form of a wealth tax?
I think taxes should go up on the most prosperous and the most fortunate, not as a penalty, but because we all have a stake as a national community in building our future. I think a wealth tax makes a lot of sense directionally. But my idea would be a much, much simpler tax system for everyone, where we eliminate all or most of the deductions, and we smooth out and simplify the system we have, and as we do, get the rates right. I don't think that wealth is the problem. I think greed is the problem. Mm-hmm. I think we want to encourage prosperity. We want to encourage people to aspire to, just like I have, to lift themselves and their families out of poverty and to move into the middle class and beyond. But it seems to me we've had a system where we have crowded and hoarded all of the benefits of our prosperity in a very, very few. This is what trickle-down economics looks like. And we've been at this for 40 or 50 years, and it is time for us to break that fever and get it right.
Okay, Governor, we'll get to hear more about where you stand on different positions, but I want to get back to the events of today, why you're getting in. Specifically, in one sentence, if you could say why you're getting in, and do you think you're sending the message to the other candidates that you don't think they can beat Donald Trump, but you can?
Well, first of all, I think I want to be clear. I'm getting in because I think there is an opportunity right now for big ideas as big as the challenges we face, and in the crafting and development of those ideas to bring us together. Right now, we have We have a really talented, really gifted, and a very hard-working and hard-sacrificing field of Democratic candidates, many of them my personal friends. But we seem to be migrating to, on the one camp, sort of nostalgia. Let's just get rid, if you will, of the incumbent president. We can go back to doing what we used to do. Or, you know, it's our way, our big idea, or no way. And neither of those, it seems to me, seizes the moment to pull the nation together and bring some humility that, frankly, we have a lot of ideas, but no one candidate, no one party has a corner on all the best ideas.
You told the Boston Globe, it's being reported this morning, that you spoke to President Obama yesterday. What advice, if any, did he give you? Did you seek his counsel on this?
Our conversations are—I want to keep confidential. They always have been.
You don't have to.
I know you want to.
You're among friends.
Yeah. I get it. I get it. And listen, he's got to—and we both agree. He has to remain neutral and wait and see who the nominee is.
I didn't ask who he was voting for, who he was thinking about, Governor. I just want to know, did he advise you on this?
I'm seeking his vote. You can be sure. Oh, sure. Yeah. I mean, he has the same— concerns and the same encouragement that concerns that you've expressed on air and encouragement that you've expressed off air, which is to say that, you know, we need to reach for the best of America, not just the best of our party and not just the best of our supporters, but the best of America. And that's going to come from a whole lot of people who have checked out and have felt, I think, rightly left out and left back. And what we want to do is bring them back in.
Governor is in the race. Deval for all. I'm sorry we have to break up like this. I hope it wasn't something. Hope it wasn't something we said. We'll talk to you again.
You always have a place in my heart.
We still love you, Governor.
Thank you, Governor.
We'll see you next time as a candidate again.